Welcome everyone, and thank you for joining us on the Rural Development Track of Charcha 2021, organized by the Nudge Forum. Do stay with us through the day and over the weekend, as we have an exciting lineup of speakers planned. We will now start our fireside chat with Dr. Achyuta Samanta on the topic of multifaceted rural transformation. Dr. Samanta is the founder and mentor, the Kalinga Institute of Industrial Technology and the Kalinga Institute of Social Sciences. His institutions have enabled rural and tribal development, working in areas as diverse as education, health, and nutrition to livelihoods and employment. Dr. Samanta has won several civilian awards from the Indian government and from other countries. He was elected Member of Parliament, Rajya Sabha, in 2018-19. Currently, Dr. Samanta is the Member of Parliament, Lok Sabha, from Biju Janata Dal. Dr. Samanta will be in conversation with Mr. Arun Seth. Mr. Seth is a founder member of the board of the Nudge Foundation, ex-chairman of British Telecom India and Alcatel-Lucent. He is a trustee at NASSCOM Foundation and was the founding chairman of the BPO Forum for NASSCOM. He is the co-chair for the Sustainable Development Council. He also serves on several boards like Domino's India, Narayana Hridalaya, and HelpAge India. Mr. Seth is an alumnus of IIT Kanpur and IIM Calcutta. Welcome to both our speakers. We're very thankful and delighted to have you with us today, and we look forward to an inspiring session. Over to you, Mr. Seth.
Thank you very much. Welcome everybody, and thank you very much for joining us today for this session, Dr. Samanta. You managed to create a model of lifting the poorest of poor from poverty using education as the basis. Let's watch a short video which tells the story of the Kalinga Institute you set up.
Kalinga Institute of Social Sciences, KISS, Bhubaneswar, India, the world's largest fully free residential educational institute and home for 27,000 poorest of the poor tribal children, including 15,000 girls, providing comprehensive and complete education from kindergarten to post-graduation with vocational and all-round skills empowerment. KISS has been fulfilling the Millennium Development Goals and the SDGs of the United Nations Organization, creating social assets and agents of change. KISS is a unique educational initiative for social transformation and peace.
Thank you. That was really very good. Dr. Samanta, one of the things I learned, a few things I learned at IIT was the difference between what is necessary and what's sufficient. What you've done in education is at scale. Is that sufficient to transform, or do we need something else to do to make this go on a sustainable basis?
You see, education is the everything for the society, for the people, for the individual. For any type of transformations, be it rural transformation, for any type of transformation, education plays the important role or key role. Because today also, you are there and I am here sitting. It is possible only because we are educated a little bit. So unless until these children or the people are educated, transformation in the society, in rural area, or in the lives is not at all possible. That we have experienced from our childhood. Particularly in my case, I have seen how education plays very important role in my own life transformation, or in the transformation of the entire villagers in the village I was born and brought up, etc. because most Reverend Arun Sethji will be happy to know that why I have told this line, that Achyut Samant today sitting before you, and the same Achyut Samant when he was only 4 years old, how the father expired when I was only 4 years old, and we are also with 7 brothers and sisters and widow mother, lived in those days during 1970 in a remote village of Odisha. And today, the same Achyut Samant, who had seen the all poverty, hunger, humiliation, everything from his childhood, from the age of 4, now is able to transform the lives of thousands and thousands poor tribal children through not education
thousands,
only.
Not thousands, tens of thousands.
So, first, Achyut Samant is able to do because he is educated, and he is transforming the lives of the thousands and thousands poor children through education only, which is the permanent solution for transformation. Because education is the permanent solution for any type of transformation. That's why I have learned these things from my childhood, and I have been using the same thing to transform the lives of thousands from the rural area again. Because unless until the transformation takes place in the rural area, we should not expect any type of transformation in the urban area or in the country or in the nation or in the society. That's why I have been doing this type of transformation through education only, whatever you have asked.
No, no, that's really wonderful. What I really went, now that you've educated so many people, we need to create, we should be able to create, you know, enough gainful employment for them in agriculture and everything. So that's not an area that you are in, or maybe I'm wrong. How do we make that whole thing whole so that they enjoy a sustainable future?
Again, I will again stick to my same thing. Education is the...
is the building block, biggest building block.
Biggest building block, everything for the sustainable development, right, or the sustainable life. If you see, we have been working for the last 30 years in the field of education, particularly with the poor children in the entire country or in our state. We have been taking care of already 60,000 poor indigenous children directly and 600,000 indirectly. And you can see, unless until these children are educated, they would not have seen the real world now we see across the entire world. So they are now able to see the real world because they are educated. After education, we can say anything. You are asking for the employment. You see, there is huge scope for the employment of these poor children or the tribal children.
Correct.
But they are not able, they are not educated, they are not having the potential, etc. Even if government has the reservation for this type of children in the job, but they are not able to enter into the job or the this type of things because they are not educated. So if they are educated, automatically employment and all the other scopes will be opened before them, and they can earn their livelihood, they can do whatever they can want, and they can also prosper in their life, because employment is not everything to them, but education is everything to them, I can say. So if education is there with them, so definitely it is very good sustainable development for them, sustainable development for the rural areas or rural people, children from the rural area, and real rural transformation will take place, or the sustainable development will continue if they are educated, and automatically they will be employed. So that's why I can say, whatever you are asking, the education plays the very important role in sustainable development, inclusive growth, and also fulfills the SDG 2030.
Correct. I agree.
Sustainable development goal of UN SDG 2030, it fulfills. We have seen in our work in the last 30 years, and I can say in this context, Arun Sherji, suppose I can give you an example. I have been doing many works. You must have seen in my biodata, etc. I have converted one remote village to smart village, an entire panchayat, cluster of village, the model panchayat. All city amenities are available in that village, known as Kaldraban. And that is in true sense, the smart village, with everything. Be it road, street light, drinking water, and the fully residential vernacular school, fully residential your English freedom school, bank, post office, police outpost, 100-bedded dispensary with telemedicine facilities, and many temples and the spiritual center, and youth club, women club, etc. And it has been running for the last 20 years very successfully. You will be happy to know that 350 people are employed in that smart village in all these entire things, all the activities going on. So, and people are getting all the city amenities there. So only because of this development in that remote village, now people or the young mass need not come to the city at all.
Yeah.
So health, education, nutrition, road, transport, and all the other modern facilities, because I have made it fully Wi-Fi and solar energy. That's what it's my. So that's why this is also, again, the sustainable development. This shows the sustainable development and everything. And it is possible,
You have answered the question completely, because beyond education, you created the rest of it. So how do we... So let me move on to something else, Dr. Samantha. You have, you know, like you said, you've been a role model, experienced real poverty while growing up. What kept you going? And would like to hear of some turning moments in your journey. Because I'm sure the audience would really like to understand life's lessons from your own life.
You are very right. My journey...
And maybe one little piece there is, sometimes you learn more from failures than from successes. So maybe one failure.
Right. Yeah, definitely. Because you see, my case is a very exceptional case, I can say. Because no doubt, many great people and many people are born poor. They also brought up in poverty. But generally, what happens, they grow vertically. Someone becomes scientist, someone becomes a bureaucrat, someone becomes minister, MLA, MP, etc. But they cannot take the entire society with him, like Pachyut Samant has been taking. Millions of people are getting bread and butter with the help of my work I have been executing for the last 30 years. So why my case is very exceptional, that Pachyut Samant, like any other child, was also born. But suddenly his father died from train accident when Pachyut Samant was only 4 years old. And during 1970 up to 84, my completion of graduation, you cannot believe the hazardous journey we all seven brothers and sisters and widow mother had gone through in that time. Because my father was a very small worker and he had not left anything for 8 members family. That's why in those days, there was no government welfare scheme or anything else. But fortunately, we are destined to come up to this position. That's why we are working here and there in the village, side by side, getting the education. And we completed, I completed my school education in my own government schools, primary or secondary, whatever the things. Then completed also college education and also master's program from the Utkal University, Bhubaneswar. So in this way, after completion of my entire things and very struggleful life, which cannot be described, and I used to describe my poverty or the struggle in two lines, that we all were so poor, we are not getting even one square meal in 2 days, and my mother had no second pair of sari to change after bath. So that type of poverty we had already seen and experienced, but we are able to get the education. Then we reached. So when I was in the age of 25, during 92-93, I thought of doing something for the society. And I started both the organizations, whatever you know, KIT and KISS, the world famous organizations now, in 2 rented house with only $100, 5,000 rupees in my pocket. So I had, or we had never thought of, that God will bless both the organizations up to these positions, whatever now it is. So there are many turning points, etc. Initially, you know, during 92-93 onwards, neither there was any globalization, nor people are flooded with money the way at present. Right. So at that time, it was very difficult. And I had no background, no backing, no banking. So initially, I was borrowing hand loans from the near and dears and friends, etc. And I can mention one thing, that how in 95, at one point of time, I had the hand loan of 15 to 16 lakhs. At that time, I 15 to 16 lakhs, and people are demanding to get back their money. I had no other way to repay the money, and I was hiding for them. So once I decided also to commit suicide, as I was not able to return the money to the people I had borrowed. So one nationalized bank, on my face value, sanctioned at that time 25 lakhs loan. So from that turning point, 95, I had never looked back. I repaid the 10 lakhs hand loan, then started the construction of Campus One. And from that level, I had come up to this level with 1.5 crore square foot built up area spreading over 25 square kilometer area, the KIT and KISS, and with 25 loss green campus and everything. So this KIT is one side, one of the most promising professional university in India, in the league of Institute of Eminence or world-class university status given by the government of India, with 30,000 students from pan-India and from 64 countries, though we are situated in Bhubaneswar. And at the same time, KISS, one of the biggest organization for the tribals, fully free, fully residential, already 30,000 students pass out, and 30,000 students in the campus from the KG to PG, standard one to master's or doctoral program. And this KISS is also the university status given by the government of India. And it is the only tribal university in the world, exclusively for the tribal children, that too fully free, fully residential. And in this context, you all might have the query, how the financially viable the KISS has been running. Because the growth of KISS has taken place with the growth of KIT. So because of my strong passion to eradicate poverty, hunger among the poorest of the poor children in the society, it has been possible for the last 29 and 30 years. In this way, I have come up to this level. Only one sentence I can say, whether you believe in me or not. Whatever I have executed, whatever I have achieved, whatever I have been doing for the last 30 years, it is only His blessings, God's blessings. Even I don't know how all these things would have come so quickly, so nicely. I am the medium or the instrument to implement the things. But everybody feels after seeing me and KIT and KISS, it is definitely destiny and it is definitely God's grace or His blessings, I can say.
No, that's a great way that you have put it. And it's a big lesson to everybody out there. So I hope people are listening and get motivated by what you say. On a different note, one of the things I read in your biodata, and also it's very topical because of what Odisha has done for Olympics, you say in your statement that sports is key. And so I'd love you to you know, tell us how important is sports in this whole education piece? Because as I was talking to you before this call, a lot of the biggest institutes have become so focused only on just pure education rather than on the social side and the sports side. Because that should build character. What's your view on that?
You see, that's why we are both Keat University, Keats University are so popular. Because of the sports activities we have been doing for the last approximately 15 years, 15, 16 years. You see, sports is, again, I can say, with education, sports is everything to the society, to the young mass, to the people. You see, now we are telling India is a young country. India is full of youth. India is having more than 65% population young. All these things we have been telling. Unless until we facilitate these young people in India, the future of India, we cannot say what it will be. If these young mass will be facilitated, then definitely we are going to get the dividend. If this young mass will not be facilitated and will not be trained, groomed, skilled, educated, facilitated means these things, then definitely there will be disaster. So I can say from my own experience, we can solve many things in the society, in the country, through sports only. If we promote the sports in a better way and bigger way, many things can be solved, be it antisocial activity, be it brotherhood, sisterhood, or the career, but in true sense. And with respect to sports, I can cite two examples. Now, Odisha is also very visible and familiar promoting sports.
Lot of medals have come thanks to Odisha.
Yeah, Odisha Honorable Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik is very much progressive to promote the sports activities. He has developed many sports infrastructure in Bhubaneswar and other parts of the state. You will be happy to know that Odisha is the only state who sponsors any one event. That is the suppose Odisha has been sponsoring the hockey.
Correct.
Of the India. And hockey is the national game. And you see, this national game was already in dormant stage. And people have already forgotten the hockey will revive at all, though it is a national game. But because of the support and sponsorship, financial support, everything from the Odisha government under the leadership of Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik ji, now this hockey revived like anything and brought laurels and pride to India by winning this bronze medal after a gap of 41 years. And also the women hockey team reached even fourth position after a gap of 66 years.
Yeah.
So besides this also, Odisha hosted World Cup hockey men in Bhubaneswar and going to host second time in 2023 also. And in this
World Cup is there in 2023.
In this context, I can also cite how we have been promoting sports like anything. Since 2005, we have been promoting sports in both the organizations, Keat and Keys. You all will be happy to know that highest sports infrastructure created in any one place in India, all international standard, that is our place, Keat and Keys.
Wow.
I have done that much of sports infrastructure. And we hosted first ever Khelo India University Games of India last year, 2020, with 4,000 athletes in 32 events. Everything happened in our campus because of the huge sports infrastructure we have created. And this time, 3 students from Keat University participated in Tokyo Olympics in 4 wow. events. In 200 meters race, our Duti Chand, and first time fencing, CA Bhavani Devi, the our student, and also Shippal Singh in javelin throw. So 3 students from Keat University participated, and we have produced 5,000 sports personnel from KISS those who are playing school level, college level, university level, state, national and international level games and sports. And I have the vision and effort to provide 5 to 10 students from KIT and KISS in every Olympic from 2024. So that's why sports is really very good. If India promotes and invests something in sports in the coming days, definitely India will be a very happy country. Youth mass will be properly engaged, etc. And there should be many opportunity for the children playing the sports. There should be job opportunity. There should be financial support. There should be sports infrastructure starting from the, again, rural area. Then only rural transformation is possible.
Correct.
So sports infrastructure should not be on the capital headquarters or any particular places, Patiala or Hyderabad or etc., etc. It should be, there should be something from the rural area. And if we engage our children from the school level to play sports or games, etc., and practice these things, you see how much it will be, it will cost for football or volleyball. So if we kabaddi, khokko, football, volleyball, these are very small expenses. But correct, children are love of football, volleyball, kabaddi, khokko, and many other things, judo, very less expenses. So if we also, government should think of promoting sports in a very big way, there will be less criminal activities.
I agree.
Will be very good spirit among the youth. There will be very good brotherhood, sisterhoods, and also children will have the very good belongingness for their own nations or the country. And India will get good mileage the way the China, Japan, America, Australia, you see this Olympics. Suppose I can say that I have heard and know that India has got 28 medals till last Olympics. One player in America has got 28 medals.
Correct. That lady is there.
You are staying in America. One player in America has got 28 medals. And India has got, in the last 120 years, only 28 medals up to the last Olympic.
No.
And how much we are happy after getting one gold medal. And it is the first gold medal in track and field.
Correct. With Neeraj. Correct. Nani, thank you very much, Dr. Samantha. That was really brilliant. And, you know, I'm going to conclude this because we have our session. This has been absolutely brilliant. And I know that from an educator, you've now joined politics. So I hope you're able to convince the government to invest in all these areas of tribal areas. The question is, how do we scale your model? Because you're a shining star in one place, but we need it across India. So I hope you'll be using your entry into parliament and your time in parliament to be able to scale your model and share your learnings with everybody. Because if everybody practices what you have done, I'm sure we can completely transform India and lift people out of poverty. So thank you very much for this wonderful session. And
thank you very much also.
And I hope that I'll be able to see you when I'm there in back in October in Delhi. Thank you very much. I hand it over to you.
Yeah. Thank you very much. I'll pay my regards to you and you will be in Delhi. And thanks to Notch Foundation for giving me an opportunity to share my activities and feelings, everything with all the listeners listening to it and watching to Notch Foundation. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Roshni, over to you.
Pleasure is all ours, sir. Thank you so much. Wonderful session. And thank you to our audience for joining us. Thank you. Bye-bye.